How are you doing today? Hope you are doing great. Welcome back to my channel. This is Phenomenal Pips. Today I'm going to share with you how to trade it, how to trade the trend perfectly, how to draw the trend line and how to trade it. So that is what we're gonna learn to this morning today. So as everybody know that we have a lot of strategies to trade with. You can trade with moving average, and you can also trade with candle formation. You can also trade with trend. Maybe you can use the trend line to trade. So we have a lot of strategies that you can trade with, and we have a lot of traders. Some traders they use only moving average to trade. So some traders they use only technical analysis to trade. What I mean by technical analysis is the like trend line, candle formation, all these channel, I said the triangle, something like that. So they use it to trade. They don't use moving average. And some traders, they use everything. They use both candle formation, trend line, moving average. They use everything that they know that it works for them. So they use everything. But today I'm going to share with you how to trade the market by using a trend line, how to do the trend line and how to trade with it. Although this video I don't want it to long, because all this program is going on my mentorship program. So, and if you want to join, then you can also do me to join the people that are already on the training. So for the people that don't know how to trade the trend line, if you want to do the trend line, it's very simple. Number one, if you open your chart, what you need to look for is that you need to check the movement of the market, whether the market is an uptrend and the market is in downtrend. So if you want to check your trend, you just need to check it when you open your chart. Maybe you want to take a trade, you don't just jump into market and click buy or click sell. No, you need to check the movement of the market before you can place your buy or you can place your sell. So you go to use technical analysis. Maybe you want to use your trend line. You need to draw your trend line. So if you want to draw your trend line, maybe you want to draw up an uptrend, or you want to draw your downtrend. What you just need to look for is you need to check. Like now, I open my charts now. I see that this is the current market now. So if you want to draw your trend line, you need to start drawing from the up. So as you can see now, you know, before drawing anything, you know that this market is in downtrend, because the market is sloping down. If the market is sloping down like this, if the market is sloping down like this, it's telling you that the market is in downtrend. But if the market come up, go up like this from here, move up like this, that is the market is in uptrend. But the market now is what is in downtrend, because it's sloping down. So if you want to draw your trend line, you need to check your what higher. You will start drawing from what, from lower high. So this is what we call lower high. Here, this is our lower high. This is our lower low. This is our lower high. This is our lower low. This is our lower high. This is our lower low. This is our lower high. This is our lower low for downtrend. But for uptrend, let me find a. So maybe I will look for another chart to show you an uptrend. But for this year, this market is in downtrend. You need to check this is our lower high and this is our lower low. So like I said, if you want to know more about how to draw the trend line and how to know current information, how to use the moving average, you can join our mentorship program to know more about them. So let's draw our trend line. Like I said, you will draw from lower high. So if you want to draw your trend line, you need to draw from where? From lower high. Let me draw from here. don't cut the candles. Don't cut the candles. Yes, don't cut the candles. So what I mean by don't cut the candle is that don't place your trend line here. Don't cut the candle. What I mean by don't cut the candle is that you draw, don't put your trend line, don't put your trend line here. So draw from the wick here. So draw from the wick here. So that is where you put your trend line. Then if you want to draw your trend line, the trend line have a rules. You will draw from the first lower high, because if you check here now, you will see that there's no higher that higher than this. This is our first high, then this is our second high. So you will target two lower high. So this is our first high and this is our second high. If you see only one high, that means you can't draw your trend line. Maybe you see only one high, so there's no other high again. So you can't draw your trend line, because this one is first high and this one is second high. Even if you do not see another high again, so you can also still use this, because we have already seen our lower high. I don't know whether you understand me. So you will draw from first high to second high, then yes, that is it. That is how we draw the trend line. First high, second high, then this is another high. So how do we know that the market is in down? We have already seen that the market is sloping down. So that is how we draw the trend line. So for experts don't need to draw going down again, but you can also draw it, because they have already seen the, what they want to use. Because for this one now, this trend line that we draw now, you can trade your market with it, because we have already know that it's in downtrend. But for downtrend, what you just need to look for is that you will look for what? You will look for selling opportunity. I don't know whether you understand me. If you see an healthy trend downtrend, what you will be looking for is selling opportunity. Don't look for buying opportunity at all. Don't look for buying opportunity. So because the market is in downtrend, what you need is this trend line here at the up here. So that is what you need. You don't need the down one, but let me draw the down one so that you'll be able to understand what I'm saying. Like I said, you go from the left, so I just draw from that. If you want to draw your trend line, start from left. Don't start from right. I just draw my own like that. So this is our first high. Let's from here. Yes. So, like I said, if you want to trade the downtrend, don't trade from here, because what we need is what? What we need is selling opportunity. We only need selling opportunity. We don't need to buy on the downtrend. Although some people, they used to do the boat, they will buy and they will still sell. But we, as an expert, you don't need to buy on downtrend. What you need to look for is selling opportunity. Then when you draw your trend line like this is our trend line. So this the downtrend here, the down trend line that you draw here, just to know how the market is moved. So that is it. But here, this is what we need for our entrance. This is our entry. So if you want to enter, you know the time to enter, and then this one can give you the time to exit the market. This one will tell you the time to exit the market. So that's it. So the trend line, we know this is our first high, this is our second high. That this one gave us the trend line. So when the market touched here, market come is sold, is sold from here to here, then it come back and tested the trend line. Then the market from here, you will sell your market from here after. So when the market touches this and the trend line, when you see the rejection, then you will go for sell from here, then you will target here or put your stop loss TP here. You put your TP around here, then your TP2 will be around here. Then when the market touches this trend line, the market goes, then it go back to this trend line and tested the trend line. So when the market tested this trend line, it was it sold from here, tested this support this trend line again. When it tested this trend line, what did you see? It go back and tested the trend line. So that is how we trade the trend line. When the market tested the trend line, you know, it didn't break it. What you just need to look for is look for the rejection. After the rejection, then you need to look for bearish candle. After the bearish candle, you will enter your sell. So that is how we trade the trend line. You will enter from your sell, you put your stop loss behind this trend line. So in case if the market go again, if market reverse and broke the trend line, and so it will hit your stop loss. So for you to lose low and to risk for you to lose small, so that's why we use to put our stop loss. So like I said, if you see that market tested the trend line, don't just place sell. No, wait for the market whether it will broke the trend line or it will reject. If you see the rejection candle, then you will see your bull and bearish candle. After the bearish candle, you will enter your sell. So you put your stop loss around here, then your TP2 will be around here. So that is how we trade it. So you will notice that because the market really respect trend line. So from here, when the market reach here, it bounced back, tested the trend line. Then when it tested the trend line, what did you see? Market go back and tested this trend line. So it respected this trend line very well. So with this trend line, you can make the market. It work for both forex and fix. So like I said, we can use the trade. So this one is for a trend line, and you can also use candle formation to trade your to trade perfectly. You can also use a moving average. You can also use all the channels, something like that, ascending triangle, all of them. They are all the technical analysis. You can use all of them to trade. But yeah, I'm just teaching you how to use the trend line to trade the market. So from here now, the market is sold. From here, even some people, they used to swing. So when they put they set their buy here, they enter from here, they will stay in the market till the market reach here, and they will not close because they know that when maybe they have already did the analysis on daily time frame and H4, they know that the market is still going down. So they will just leave their trade and they will use to trail their market. What I mean by trail is that when they put it, they start and maybe they start entering from here. When they open their trade from here, the market sold, reach here, they bounce back, sold again. When it sold, they will just put their they will lock their profit. Maybe from here to here is already give them like $50. Then they are $50, they will lock $30 out of that $50. In case the market want to gaze against them, it will eat their out of that $50. They will they have already locked $30, so they will be in profit if the market want to do it there. So that is it. So it's very simple. If you want to know more about this, you can join our mentorship program. So that is it. Thank you very much.
I really appreciate you guys.